In this video, we are going to see unbalanced transportation problem. Before we see the problem, let us see some important points briefly. See, the objective of transportation problem is to minimize the total transportation cost. Okay, the transportation problem can be classified into two different categories. The first one is balanced transportation problem and the second one is unbalanced transportation problem. Balanced transportation problem means both demand and supply will be equal. Okay, unbalanced means demand will not be equal to supply. This is called as unbalanced. Let us see the example for balanced and unbalanced. So look at this matrix. Here there are three sources and three destinations. So this one is supply and this one is demand. Look at the supply total for the first two sources. 10, for the second one 30, for the third one 60, total 100. Look at the demand, for the first column total 20, for the second column 30, for the third column 50, total 100. So here demand is equal to supply. So this one is balanced transportation problem. Look at the second matrix, this one is unbalanced. See here the supply is 10 plus 30 plus 60, 100, whereas demand is 20 plus 25 plus 45, 90. So here demand is not equal to supply because demand is 90 but supply is 100. So this type of problem is called unbalanced. We have already uploaded a separate video for balanced transportation problem. So here we are going to see unbalanced transportation problem. So before we see the problem, let me explain the three different methods of solving transportation problem. See, the methods of solving transportation problem, it has two phases, phase 1 and phase 2. Phase 1 is finding the initial basic solution. This is the first phase. There are three techniques available to find out the initial basic solution. Okay, the first method is northwest corner cell method and the second one least cost cell method and the third one Vogel's approximation method. These are the three techniques available in phase 1 in order to find out the initial basic solution. After finding the initial basic solution, then we can go for phase 2. Phase 2 is just optimizing the basic feasible solution by using UV method. So this part I have already explained in a separate video. So here we are going to see only phase 1. Okay, and we are going to apply the three techniques in order to find out the initial basic solution. Let us see the problem. Look at the problem. Find the initial basic feasible solution to the following transportation problem by using northwest corner cell method and second one least cost cell method and the third one Vogel's approximation method. You must know that after finding the solution according to three different methods, the cost of the initial basic feasible solution through VAM will be the least among all three techniques. We will see the result finally. Okay, look at the matrix. There are five destinations and four sources. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sources. A, B, C, D, E. 5 destinations. Supply 15, 25, 42, 35. And demand 30, 20, 15, 10 and 20. Okay, now with this information, they ask you to find out the initial basic feasible solution by using three different methods. In order to proceed the problem, first we need to check the total demand and supply. Okay, if it is equal, then it is called balanced transportation problem. If it is not equal, then it is called as unbalanced transportation problem. Look at the supply total. 15 plus 25 plus 42 plus 35, 117. Look at the demand total. 30 plus 20 plus 15 plus 10 plus 20, 95. See, demand total is 95, whereas supply total is 117. So this problem is unbalanced transportation problem. Why? Because demand is not equal to supply. So now You have to convert the unbalanced transportation problem into balanced transportation problem by simply adding one more column. That is, you need to add dummy column in order to balance this value. Okay, so what is the difference? 95. Here, 117. So, 117 minus 95. You will be getting 22, no? So you need to add one more column in order to convert the unbalanced into balanced. Look at the problem. Supply total is 117, whereas demand total is only 95. You need to add one more column in order to convert the unbalanced into balanced. So how much is shortage? 22. So write 22 here. Now it is 117. So for this particular column, this column is dummy column, so that you have to put 0. Okay, now this one is 117 and supply also 117. Now the unbalanced transportation problem is converted into balanced one. Now see the solution. Look at the problem. They ask you to find out the initial basic feasible solution by using three different techniques. The first one, northwest corner cell method, and second one, least cost cell method, and the third one, Ogle's approximation method. Now let us see the problem for the first method, that is northwest corner cell method. Look at the procedure for northwest corner cell method. So according to northwest corner cell method, you have to start the procedure from the northwest corner cell. Look at the matrix. You have to start from the northwest corner. So in this matrix, which one is northwest? This one is northwest corner. You have to start from here. Now see the second procedure. The second step is allocate the least value by comparing demand and supply. You need to compare demand and supply and you have to allocate the least value in the northwest corner cell. See, this cell is the northwest corner cell. So now you have to compare the supply and demand. For this particular element, this is the supply and this is the demand. So demand is 30, whereas supply is 15 for this particular cell. Okay, so which one is least? Supply, that is 15, is least value when compared to 30. Now allocate the least value, that is 15 is the least value. So after allocating this value, this will be 0 and this will be 15. So after allocating 15, the remaining demand is 15. Now here, the entire supply is allocated to this particular cell. No. So this will be 0. Now the entire row will get cancelled. Okay. So after deleting the first row, now look at the remaining matrix and select the northwest. So which one is northwest? This cell is the northwest. Now compare the demand and supply. So demand is 15, whereas supply is 25. So which one is least? Demand is least when compared to supply. So allocate 15 here. Okay, so after allocating 15, the remaining amount is 10. Okay, here you will be getting 0. Now this column will get cancelled because of 0. Okay, after deleting the first column, now see the remaining matrix. Again, you have to select the northwest corner. So which one is northwest corner? This cell is the northwest corner. So select this particular cell and compare the demand and supply. Demand is 20 and supply is 10. Which one is least? 10 is least. So allocate 10 and here you'll get 0 and here you'll be getting 10. So after allocating 10, the remaining amount is 10. So now this row will get cancelled. Now after deleting the second row, look at the remaining matrix. Again select the northwest. So this is the northwest corner. Now select this particular cell and compare the demand and supply. So demand is 10, whereas supply is 42. So which one is least? Demand is least. No. So put 10 here. And you'll be getting 0 and here the balance amount is 32. Here the demand is 0, so cancel this particular column. So after deleting these things, look at the remaining matrix. Now which one is northwest? this is the northwest, no? So select this particular cell and compare the demand and supply, 32 and 15. Which one is least? 15 is the least, no? So put 15 here, you'll be getting 0. Here the balance is 17. So 0, no? Just cancel this particular column. Now in the remaining matrix, which one is northwest? This one is northwest, no? Select this particular cell and compare the demand and supply. And which one is least? 10 is the least, no? So put 10 here. And here you'll be getting balance 7. So because of this, this particular column will get cancelled. Okay, now look at the remaining cell and select the northwest. So this is the northwest corner. Select this particular cell and compare 20 and 7. 7 is the least value. So you 0, balance 13. So because of this, this particular row will get cancelled. Now look at the remaining cell. Which one is northwest? This is the northwest. So select this particular cell, compare the demand and supply. Which one is least? 13 is the least value, no? So 0. Here you will be getting 22. So 13. Because of this, this will be get cancelled. Finally, here we have only one cell. Here the demand and supply is equal, 22 and 22, and put the same value, 22. That's all. Okay, now look at the procedure. After completing this procedure, the next one is add the products of all allocated cells, which means multiply the allocated value with the cost of particular cell and finally add all the products. Let me show the calculation. Look at the solution matrix. Now multiply the allocated value with the cost of the particular cell and finally add all the values. For the first one, 15 into 5 and then 15 into 3 plus 10 into 9 plus 10 into 2 plus 15 into 7 plus 10 into 6 plus 7 into 5 plus 13 into 9 plus 22 into 0. You will be getting total transportation cost. 15 into 5 plus 15 into 3 plus 10 into 9 plus 10 into 2 plus 15 into 7 plus 10 into 6 plus 7 into 5 plus 13 into 9 plus 22 into 0. After multiplying the allocated value with the cost of a particular cell and finally you need to add the total products. The total amount is 547. Okay, this is the total transportation cost according to northwest corner cell method. Look at the problem. Now we have done the first method, northwest corner cell method. Now let us see the second method, that is least cost cell method. Look at the simple procedure to solve the problem by using least cost cell method. The first procedure is find the minimum value in the cost matrix. So among the entire matrix, you need to find out the minimum value. If you find more than one or two values, same value, then you can select randomly any one least value. See, in the total matrix, find out the least value. So which one is least value? 0 is the least value, no? Here we have got 4 zeros. You can select any one randomly. So I am going to start with the first value. Okay, so I am going to select this particular cell. After finding the minimum value in the entire cost matrix, the remaining procedure is same as we did in the first method. The second step is allocate the least value by comparing demand and supply. For this particular selected cell, the demand and supply value is supply 15 and demand value is 22. So which one is least? 15 is the least value, no? So allocate 15. Here you will be getting 0 and here the remaining value is 7. So in this particular row will get cancelled because of 0. After deleting the first row, now look at the remaining cell and find out the least value. Again, 0 is the least value. Here we have 3 zeros. So I am going to select any one. So select this particular cell and compare the demand and supply. So demand 7, supply 25 and demand is lesser value, no? So allocate 7. Here you will get 0. Here the balancing value is 18. Okay, now this particular column will get cancelled because of 0. Now, in the remaining cell, which one is least value? 2 is the least value. So, I am going to select this particular cell and I am going to compare the demand and supply. Demand is 20, supply is 42. So, demand is lesser than the 42. So, allocate 20, here you will be getting 0 and here the balance amount is 22. So, because of this, this particular column will get cancelled. Now, look at the remaining cell and find out the least value. So 3 is the least value and compare the demand and supply. Demand 30 and supply is 18. So 18 is the least value. So allocate 18. Okay, here you'll be getting 0. The balance amount is 12. So because of this 0, this particular row will get cancelled. Okay, in the remaining cells, which one is least value? 4 is the least value. Here we have got 2 4s. So you can select any one. So I am going to select the first 4. Okay, now compare the demand and supply. Demand is 12 and supply is 22. So demand value is lesser than the supply. So 0. Here the balance is 10. So because of this, this particular column will get cancelled. Now in the remaining cells, which one is least? 4 is the least value, no. So, I am going to select this particular cell and compare demand and supply. So, demand is lesser than supply. So, allocate 10, balance 25. So, because of this, this column will get cancelled. Okay, in the remaining undeleted value, which one is least? 5 is the least, no. Select this particular cell and compare 20, 10. 10 is the least value. So, 0. Here you will be getting 10. So because of 0, this particular row will get cancelled. Now we have only 2 cells. Among these 2 values, which one is least? 9 is the least. No. Select this particular cell and allocate the least value by comparing demand and supply. Demand 10, supply 25. So allocate 10, balance 15, here 0 and cancel this particular column. Now we have only 1 element. Okay, here the demand value for this particular cell is 15 and supply again 15. The final value will be equal. Demand and supply will be equal for the last cell. So put 15. Okay. Now finally just multiply the allocated value with the respective cost of the particular cell and finally add the product of all allocated values. 15 into 0 plus 18 into 3 plus 7 into 0 plus 12 into 4 plus 20 into 2 plus 10 into 5 plus 15 into 10 plus 10 into 4 plus 10 into 9. You'll be getting total transportation cost according to least cost cell method. 15 into 0 plus 18 into 3 plus 7 into 0 plus 12 into 4 plus 20 into 2 plus 10 into 5 plus 15 into 10 plus 10 into 4 plus 10 into 9, you'll be getting 472. So according to least cost cell method, the total transportation cost is 472. Look at the problem. So far we have done 2 methods. The first one is northwest corner method and the second one least cost method. Now we'll see the third one, that is Vogel's approximation method for the same problem. Now let us see the procedure to solve the problem. So here we have 5 steps. The first one is find out the row difference and column difference. Okay, let me explain each and every point along with the problem. So first we are going to find out the row difference and column difference. Look at the problem. The first step is you need to find out the row difference and column difference. I'll tell you how to find out row difference and column difference. Look at the first row and select the least cost in the first row. So which one is least cost? 0 is the least cost and then find out the second least cost. The next least cost is 1. Now find out the difference between 0 and 1. What is the difference? 1. In the same way, find out the difference for each and every row. Look at the second row. What is the least value? 0 is the least value. The second least value is 3. What is the difference between these two? 3. In the same way, look at the third row. The least value is 0. Next least value is 2. Difference 2. In the fourth row, least value is 0. Next least value 4. Difference 4. Okay. So this is the way to find out the row difference. In the same way, you need to find out the column difference also. Look at the first column. In the first column, the least value is 3. The next least value is 4. Difference between these two values, 1. In the second column, least value is 1. Next least value is 2. Difference, 1. In the third column, least value is 6. Next one, 7. Difference, 1. In the next column, the least value is 4. Next least value is 6. Difference, 2. In the fifth column, the least value is 5. The next least value also 5 only, no. So here we'll be getting 0. In the last one, 0, 0. So you'll be getting 0. Okay, now look at the second procedure. Now we have got the row difference and column difference. After finding row difference and column difference, the second step is select the maximum value among row difference and column difference. Here you need to find out the maximum value among the row difference and column difference. Look at the solution. In the row difference as well as column difference, select the maximum value. Which one is maximum value, highest value? 4 is the highest value, no. So select this particular element, and now this elements represent this particular row. Now look at the procedure. After finding the maximum difference, that is among row difference and column difference, you have selected maximum value, no. After finding this, identify the cell for allocation which has least cost in that particular row or column. Okay, look at the solution table. See, after finding the maximum value, so this particular value represents the fourth row. Okay, in this particular row, you need to select the least cost. Okay, which one is least cost in this particular cell? 0 is the least cell, no. So select this particular cell for allocation. Okay, so after this, the next procedure is, after finding the least cost for allocation, now you need to allocate the least value by comparing demand and supply. Now you have selected this particular cell with the help of the procedure. Now you need to compare demand and supply for this particular cell. So demand for this particular cell is 22, whereas supply is 35. Now compare these two values and find out the least one. Which one is least? 22 is the least value, no. So allocate 22 here. Okay, here you'll get 0. After allocating this, you'll be getting 0. Here you'll be getting 13. Okay, now, so this particular column will get cancelled. So just strike out. After deleting this particular column, again you have to do the same procedure. That is, you need to find out row difference with the unallocated cell value. In the same way, you need to find out the column difference. And among the row difference and column difference, you need to select the maximum value and just repeat the same procedure. Now, you need to find out the row difference with the remaining cells. See, in the first row, the least value is 1. The next least value is 5. What is the difference? 4. In the second row, least value is 3. Next least value is 6. Difference? 3. In the third row, 2, 4. Difference? 2. In the next row, the least value is 4. Next least value is 7. Difference? 3. In the same way, find out the column difference. In the first column, 3, 4. Difference? 1. Second column, 1, 2, difference 1. In the third column, 6, 7, difference 1. Here, 4, 6, difference 2. Here, 5, 5, difference 0. Here, nothing. Now, among these difference, you need to select the maximum value. So, 4 is the maximum value, no. Select this value. Now, in this particular first row, select the least element. So, least cost. Here, you have got least value, no. So, now we are going to allocate this cell by comparing demand and supply. So, which one is least? Demand for this particular column is 20, whereas supply is 15. So, 15 is least value, no. So, allocate 15. here you'll be getting 0, here remaining 5. So here this particular row will get cancelled. Okay, now with the unallocated value, you need to find out the row difference and column difference. And just repeat the same procedure. In the first row, put dash, nothing is there, no. So put dash. In the second row, the least value is 3. Next least value 6. So difference 3. In the third row, least value is 2. Next least value 4. Difference 2. In the last row, the least value is 4. The next least value is 7. Difference 3. In the same way, you need to find out the column difference. Look at the first column. The least value is 3. The next least value is 4. Difference 1. In the second column, 2, 9, difference 7. In the third column, 6, 7, difference 1. Next column, 4, 6, difference 2. 5, 8, difference 3, dash. Among these values, which one is highest value? 7 is the highest value. So select this particular column. Now in this particular column, select the least value. 2 is the least value. No. Now I'm going to allocate this particular cell by comparing demand and supply. So which one is least value? Demand is least value. So enter 5. Here you'll be getting 0. Here balance 37. So this particular column will get cancelled. Again, repeat the same procedure. Find out row difference and column difference with the undeleted values. Look at the second row. Least value 3. Next least value 6. Difference 3. In the next row, least value is 4. Next least value 5. Difference 1. In the last row, least value 4. Next least value 7. Difference 3. The same way. Column difference. Least value 3, 4, difference 1, here dash, next 6, 7, difference 1, next 4, 6, difference 2, then 5, 8, difference 3, dash. Now among these values, find out the maximum one. 3 is the maximum value. Here we have tie, 3, 3, 3. You can select any one. So I'm going to select the first one. Now, in this particular row, select the least value. So, 3 is the least value, no. So, I'm going to allocate this particular cell by comparing demand and supply. So, demand 30, supply 25. So, 25 is the least value, no. So, put 25, 0, here you'll be getting 5. So, this particular row will get cancelled. Again, find out the row difference and column difference. So first row nothing is there, dash, dash. In the third row, least value 4, next least value 5, difference 1. And last row, 4, 7, difference 3, column difference. 4, 7, difference 3, next is 7, 10, difference 3, then 4, 6, difference 2, 5, 9, difference 4, dash. Now among these difference, find out the maximum. 4 is the maximum value. So I'm going to select this particular column. In this particular column, select the least value. 5, 9. So which one is least value? 5 is the least value. No. Now I'm going to allocate this particular cell by comparing demand and supply. Demand 20, supply 37. So 20 is the least value. So allocate 20, balance 17. Now this particular column will get cancelled. Again, repeat the same procedure. Find out the row difference and column difference. Dash, dash, here difference 4, 6, difference 2, here 4, 7, difference 3. Now find out the column difference 4, 7, difference 3, dash, 7, 10, difference 3, then 4, 6, difference 2, dash, dash. Now select the maximum value. Which one is maximum value? 3. Here we have got 3 3s. 3, 3, 3. So I am going to select the first one. So now in this particular row, which one is least value? 4 is the least value. Select this particular cell and just allocate by comparing demand and supply. 10, 13. 10 is the least value. So 0. Here balance 3. So this particular column will get cancelled. Again find out the row difference and column difference. Dash dash difference 4 7, difference 3. Here difference 7 10, difference 3. Okay, for the column difference 4 7, difference 3. Dash 7 10, difference 3. Dash dash dash. So among these value, which one is highest value? 3. So I'm going to select the first value, 3. Now look at this particular row, which one is least value? 4 is the least value. I'm going to allocate this particular cell by comparing demand and supply. Demand 5, supply 17. So enter 5, 0. Here balance 12. Okay, so this particular column will get cancelled. And finally, you have only one value in the particular row. Here also we have got only one value in the particular row. Now you can select any one value which is least cost. 7 is the least cost, no. So I'm not going to compare any difference, because here we have got only one value in the particular row. Here also only one value. So I'm going to select the least value among these two. 7 is the least value, no. Select this particular cell and compare demand and supply. So demand 15, supply 12. So enter 12 here, balance 3, 0. So cancel. Finally, I've got only one cell. Now we can compare demand and supply. Finally, you'll be getting equal value. For the last cell, when you allocate the last cell, you'll be getting equal value. The demand and supply will be equal. Okay, here 3, 3, enter 3, 0. 0. So after allocating all these things, now just multiply the allocated cell value in order to find out the total transportation cost. That is 15 into 1 plus 25 into 3 plus 5 into 4 plus 5 into 2 plus 12 into 7 plus 20 into 5 plus 3 into 10 plus 10 into 4 plus 22 into 0. You'll be getting total transportation cost according to VAM method. 15 into 1 plus 25 into 3 plus 5 into 4 plus 5 into 2 plus 12 into 7 plus 20 into 5 plus 3 into 10 plus 10 into 4 plus 22 into 0. You will be getting 374. According to Ogle's approximation method, the total transportation cost is 374. See the comparison of total cost of the three different methods. According to Northwest Corner method, the total transportation cost is 547. According to least cost method, 472. According to VAM method, 374. From this comparison, it is clearly shows that VAM gives the best initial basic feasible solution for the given problem, because its total transportation cost is minimum when compared to that of the other two methods. Hope you all understood this concept. Thank you.